ZWCAD 2024 is finally out, and in today's video, I'm going to be showing you how to use some of my favorite new features. So I'm going to be showing you how to use the area table to automatically generate tables, how to use or how to import point clouds into ZWCAD, how to use Flexiblocks, and finally, how to utilize the quick properties. Overall, ZWCAD 2024 offers an impressive array of features that cater to diverse needs of professionals across various industries. Let's go. Now, if you don't know, ZWCAD is a CAD software with full DWG compatibility, and the UI is quite familiar with AutoCAD. And now, I really like ZWCAD because of all of these smart features that they offer, and I actually created a whole video on smart features in ZWCAD, the previous version, and I'm going to link it up in the cards above if you want to check it out. And now, with the new version, we have some new interesting smart features, which I really appreciate, and also what kind of sets the ZWCAD apart from other CAD softwares is its extreme speed. So whether you're opening files, making some changes, making some large selections, or editing large hatches, or even just installing the software, ZWCAD is going to be really, really fast compared to the competition. It also supports powerful APIs, and it offers a one-time fee with a perpetual license, which is something that's really rare with software these days. Now, if you want to check ZWCAD out, I'm also going to be leaving a link to that up in the cards above, and then also down in the description of this video. And full disclosure, this is a sponsored video. So now, without any further ado, let's jump into ZWCAD. Now, I'm going to be showing you how you can automatically generate an area table with just a few steps. So what you want to do is you want to go here to the Annotate tab, and then we have the Area Table button. So that's going to open up the area table, and here I'm just going to set the naming to auto. Let's set the start number to 1, and then also we can generate a table, we can calculate the sum area, which is something I want. We can also output the area or the area table, so that's something else that I want to do. And then I'm just going to start picking the points. So let's go here to pick points, and now first I want to define basically where that table is going to be located, which is going to be here. And now as soon as I start clicking, it's going to recognize the boundary of that room, and it's going to name that automatically, in this case this room 1, 2, 3, and here it's already feeding that information into the area table. So once I'm happy with selecting all of the rooms, let's say this is all of the rooms for this project, I'm just going to hit enter, and that's also going to open up Excel where it has actually saved the area for all of those rooms. So basically it's going to give us all of this information quickly. And now we can use this Excel table, or we can use the table which we have here in the project. Now we're going to be talking about flexi blocks, or as the name would imply, flexible blocks. So these are quite similar to dynamic blocks in AutoCAD, and you can actually edit AutoCAD dynamic blocks inside of ZWCAD. Now, to explain what flexi blocks do, it's basically when you have a block that needs to be flexible. So here I have this table with 2 chairs. Let's say I want to have a table with 2 chairs, but I also might need a table with 4, 6, 10 chairs, and so on. Well, I can have 10 different blocks, or I can have one flexible block that can kind of be adjusted to each specific occasion. Now, to create a flexi block or a flexible block, what you need to do is first create a block. So let's go here to create. Let's call this one our test block, and let's select the entities, and that's going to be pretty much everything that we have on screen here. Hit enter, and then we're going to click OK. And now if I select this, as you can see, the whole thing is a block. So now I can just double click on this block and go to edit block definition, pick out our test block, and then hit OK. So here it's going to open up our block in this environment, and here we can apply different parameters or actions. So for parameters, we have point, linear, polar, x, y, and so on. And then for actions, we have move, stretch, polar stretch, scale, rotate, flip, and array. Now, in this particular case, I first want to add a parameter. So this will be a linear parameter going from here to here. So it's a distance parameter, and place it like that. Then I want to add a stretch action to that. So I'm just going to select the parameter first. Then I'm going to say, okay, so I want the stretch happening here, and this is what's going to be stretched, and hit enter, and then we can place that stretch here. Finally, we want to add an array, which is going to multiply the number of chairs. So let's now click here on the distance, and then we can select the two items that should be arrayed, hit enter, and then we also need to apply the distance, which here I'm just going to set it at something like 70, or yeah, let's actually go up to 80 or something like that, and then let's place the array here. Also, I'm going to select this distance parameter, and then in the properties panel, if you don't want to have kind of a linear change, you can go here to value set and then change that to incremental, and then you can add the increments here. So we can set this to 50 or something like that, to have a incremental distance with which we increase the length of this table. Okay, so once you're happy with all of the changes that are applied, so you're happy with how everything is set up, you can just go here to close block, and you're going to save the changes. And now when you select it, you're going to get these two arrows at each side. And when I select this, I can go by that 50 centimeter increment, as you can see, and it's going to add chairs, and it's going to increase the length of the table. So we have our flexible Flexiblock, our block, which can increase or decrease the length of the table or number of chairs depending on our project needs. Now I'm going to be talking about my favorite new feature, which is importing point clouds, which we can attach as external references. So let me show you. You want to go here to the Insert tab, and then you want to go to Point Cloud and Point Cloud Attach. Now here we need to locate the point cloud, and here you'll see all of the supported formats. So we have the RCS, RCP, and many others. I'm just going to hit open here. Now here we have some settings in terms of setting up the location and additional settings. Now I'm just going to click OK, and that's going to bring in my point cloud, and this is what that looks like. And as you can see, the navigation is really quick, so it's running really fast with this point cloud. Now when you select the point cloud, you can adjust the display in terms of level of detail, and also you can adjust the point size here. So let's make it a bit more detailed. There we go. And then we have also the option to adjust the transparency if we want. I'm just going to bring that down. We can set up the colors, so we can use object colors, we can use normal colors, or we can use the scan colors. Now moving forward, we also have ability to cut a section plane in our point cloud. So if I go here to section plane, and then select top, it's going to basically cut a section plane through our model or through the point cloud. Now I can select the section plane itself, and then I can go here to geometry, and I can specify the elevation at which we're cutting. So the section offset can be changed, so I can set it to something like 5,000, so it's going to be a bit lower. I can go up to 12,000, so it's going to be higher. Let's try something like this, or even go to perhaps 14. There we go. So this is one of the abilities that we have. Now we also have the option to change the type of this. So it can be a section plane, or it can actually be a slice. So when I set it to a slice, I actually have the option to set the slice thickness. So if I set this to 1000 millimeters, it's going to just give us a small slice of this point cloud. Now this is particularly useful if you want to get something like a floor plan out of your point cloud. So I can just go here to custom, set this to this view to be kind of from top. I can select that point cloud and then go here to selection line extraction, and I can extract either lines or 2D polylines. And when I click create, you can see we have now a set of lines following the point cloud in this particular slice which we have created. Now let me show you the feature of the quick properties panel. So whenever you select something in ZWCAD, you're going to have this properties panel, and it's going to display all of the properties for the element which you have selected. Now in a lot of cases this is fine, but in some cases you might not need all of that information, and it might be hard to kind of pinpoint where is the exact information that you need, and also it might be taking up a bit more space on your screen. Now some people prefer to work in the kind of full screen mode, and here the properties panel just doesn't fit. Well, we have the quick properties panel, which we can turn on by clicking here on quick properties, and now whenever I select an item, we're going to get this, well, quick properties panel, which is only going to give us kind of reduced information, only what we need. Now, what you need may depend on the projects you're working on or just your own style and approach. Well, to customize it, you can just click here on this button to customize, and it's going to open up a whole customization menu. And then here you can select different items, which you can select like a 2D polyline. And then these are all of the properties which we can get for that. And you can just check on the properties that you want. You can go for the 3D polyline, then this is what we have, then we have the 3D objects, we have arcs, arrays, so on and so forth. So you can basically make sure that you check only the stuff that you need and that you're actually going to use, so you can quickly locate it on that small panel once it opens up when you select one of the elements. And of course you can always close it up even while you still have the selection. And that's going to conclude today's video. So I hope you have enjoyed it. I hope you have learned something new. Again, if you're interested in checking out ZWCAD, you can follow the link up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. And I'll be back with another Balkan Arctic tutorial in a few days. Have a nice day.